ladies and gentlemen. The next speaker of our afternoon session is Professor Tomoyuki Inui from the Kyoto University. And he likes to speak about the dynamic feature of catalytic surface during the reaction of NOx composition under oxygen excess conditions.
Thank you, Chairman. Different from the condition of ammonia selective reduction of NO in diesel exhaust always contains much oxygen, sometimes 16%, and then it interferes the reaction. This is more than 20 years ago, we tested a various kind of supported partly reduced iron group metal oxide catalyst, and the NO can rather easily decompose at a very low temperature, even at low temperature below 300 degrees. And then reaction can advance stoichiometrically, but oxygen about immediately coat on the surface, and only nitrogen can detect in the effect. And then this is only stoichiometry, so what it should call the catalytic reaction. And that if we add some oxygen in the gas, so reactant gas, this reaction couldn't occur anymore. Because the oxidation by molecular oxygen predominant before NO decomposition. But as you know, very famous, most recently, Professor Iwamoto of Hokkaido University presented a paper by the effect of so iron exchange copper exerts NO decomposition activity, but under the condition of O2 absent. But this is, we calculate the state of ion exchange of copper on the typical protonated ZSM5 by minimizing energy by using molecular dynamics. And then the copper exists on the wall of the channel core exposed. So if after calcination and then remove the high, HO group, still remains Cu at a very low valence stage. And then indeed this kind of material exerts NO decomposition without so serious deactivation. So and then this our experiment showed almost 50 times, at least 8 hours can decompose O2 with not only nitrogen but also oxygen can evolve by this reaction. But we have a lot of experience in supporting copper catalysts, very weak, especially at higher temperature. Especially this copper is exposed on the channel wall. So we didn't choose this method, but instead of this, we adopted copper incorporated silicate having the ZSM5 type structure. But unfortunately, this copper is tightly incorporated, and then at the appearance, the activity about one third of compared with the ion chain ZSM5. And then consistently coincide the redox property between copper ion exchange and the copper incorporated silicate. This is a comparison. So copper can exchange by ion exchange up to 200% of from the viewpoint of proton, because copper can be ion exchange CuOH minus. But unfortunately, incorporated system, only 0.6 weight percent can incorporate in this framework. But both of them, if there's some excess oxygen condition in the reactor gas, none of them we cannot observe any so steady state of anaerobic decomposition. And then, of course, we can confirm the stability of redox cycle repeatedly. This aldol change one is very weak against this kind of redox. And practically, some of the Japanese car maker already tested by this material and then easily can so deteriorate. But if we can choose some conventional kind of zeolite structure, fortunately, copper can incorporate much more than GSF type systems. And then, very interesting, in case of A-type zeolite, in this case, we can incorporate 8.68% of copper. And then, actually, we can observe very clearly two-step reduction stage, like this. It means, so the copper oxide can be reduced with the hydrogen stream, and so clearly differentiate two stages by this way. And then it means somewhat stabilized by capture the framework of zeolite, copper one state is stable in this kind of zeolite matrix. And we compare the NO decomposition, of course these materials contain much copper, but practical activity for NO decomposition, in this case without absent, without oxygen in the gas phase, sometimes we can observe much more activity at lower temperature than ion exchange GSM5, copper ion exchange GSM5. And then I can so conclude. So first point, so NO can decompose itself occur rather easily on a highly dispersed support reducible transition metal oxide catalyst at considerably low temperature under auto absent condition. But the activity cannot be maintained because of the oxidation of the surface. And then next, zeolite, zeolitic materials which involves transition metal oxide by means of either ion exchange method or isomorphous substitution method. These can maintain their NO decomposition activity without reactivation, but due to keeping their intermediate oxidation state. The next factor is the nature of hydrocarbon combustion. So we can observe the catalytic combustion on the same catalyst surface when we change the number of carbons in normal saturated hydrocarbons. We can observe the same catalytic combustion conversion, so the temperature decreases with an increased carbon number of hydrocarbons, but it seems to be saturated around hexane or heptane, because at higher normal hydrocarbon cleavage before combustion, and this is almost the same temperature can be obtained. But in case of light hydrocarbon, it can combust completely to produce carbon dioxide water, but in this higher hydrocarbon produce many kinds of partial oxidation products. So I shortly summarized on the hydrocarbon combustion. Degree of catalytic combustion of hydrocarbons depends on their structure. Hydrocarbon can burn up to reduce metallic surfaces and even at oxidized surface, but at higher temperatures. I will show some evidence. Now we advance in the mixture of NO oxygen and some kind of hydrocarbon. But in this case, still oxygen excess ratio from the viewpoint of stoichiometry is somewhat lower than unity. But still we can observe the effect of hydrocarbon on the NO compartment on the same catalyst surface. If we choose some this kind of spectrum, the NO can convert more lower temperature range. At around more than octane, we can observe not so much temperature difference between the kinds of hydrocarbons. We can see the octane and decan and normal hexadecan. It's a representative of diesel oil, the sort of hexane. Different from hydrocarbon combustion, from the viewpoint of NO, NO always increase with an increase of temperature accompanied with hydrocarbon combustion, but in general speaking, NO decrease at a higher temperature. But using normal hexane, we can observe a more wide window. I will mention the reason. So I can summarize in this point. Addition of small concentration of NO does not affect on the oxidation of hydrocarbon. The late determining step for NO conversion is in the oxidation of hydrocarbon. There is some. So it means catalyst should not be limited in copper so loaded geotic material. Now we can see this is an example of non-metal containing silicate having a GSM5 pentathlon structure, but almost always very GPL order of aluminium is contained as a contaminant during the preparation. Still, we can observe some NO conversion at higher temperature range, and the cetan can combust very monotonously increase with the temperature increase. And then next we can see in case of gallium-silicate. Gallium is partly reducible compared with an aluminium. And then NO conversion, that's the tendency is almost same as aluminum silicate, but somewhat increase in higher temperature range. This is iron containing metal silicate. In this case, cetan can combust very lower temperature and then attain at almost 100% conversion into almost carbon dioxide, complete combustion products. Then NO, this is if hydrocarbon can combust too easily, this is no effect, almost very small effect on the NO conversion. Because maybe most of the hydrocarbon too easily combust at the entrance of the reaction zone. And then if we modify partly by platinum, of course, so cetan conversion shift lower temperature side, but improperly, it's more effective. So, merit. But if we choose some proper kind of catalyst, like a cobalt isomorph substituted silicate, in this case, the reaction temperature around 400 degrees C, it's just fit for hydrocarbon conversion and then NO conversion increase at about 70% in conversion, and then decrease on the outer of the higher temperature range. And this activity is roughly proportional on the content of cobalt in case inside the cobalt facility. And then if we change the content of cobalt, the temperature range of the catalytic reaction will also change roughly. After many catalytic reactions, we summarize the general tendency in conceptual figure like this. This is hydrocarbon combustion without anyone. And then if we can observe the normal central this kind of logistic car, LMH, it's a bit define the temperature range at the moment. And next, we add some very small amount of hydro NO addition. Then we can observe NO conversion like this. But just as I said before, hydrocarbon conversion cannot change. What will happen in this reaction system? This is supposition that the oxidation of state of catalyst may be decreased around this medium temperature range, and then at higher temperature range, oxidation again put on that. And actually, if we analyze the product in the gas, in the gas phase, very precisely was using a mass spectral gas mass spectrometer. And then we found the various kind of very complex products in the range of low temperature range and middle temperature range. At a higher temperature range, it's 10 to almost a total conversion of hydrocarbons. And then I will summarize the various kind of metal silicate and then conclude if the catalyst has a moderate acidity and redox properties, then we can have a maximum, optimum NO decomposition results. Now we change to the reaction mechanism. Professor Iwamoto and many other Japanese researchers proposed a mechanism of this extraordinary reaction condition by using the conventional classical reaction mechanism. So it's a hydrocarbon absorbed on the surface of oxygen absorbed site, and then react with the NO absorbed, this normal kind. But please note, this kind of reaction cannot occur so easily on the reaction surface. So they suppose this something, this intermediate is very so active species, but there is no evidence on this kind of species. And then possible elemental reaction to realize this reaction, this more simple reaction should occur, but no evidence, because in practice there are many complex reactions in that area. Finally, I would like to propose the different reaction mechanism. It's simply very small amount of hydrocarbon can combust on the surface of the oxidative surface, and then after that, NO have a chance to decompose on the partly reduced this way. Okay, I can explain. This morning, Professor Block explained the some oscillating reaction. It's almost the same concept on my conservation. You can reduce the surface, NO can decompose easily by proposing my first slide. And then the oxidative surface, only hydrocarbon can combust even at the fully oxidized component. That's the same point of like oscillation mechanism. But in case of oscillation reaction, fully surface synchronized. But in this case, we can consider microstructurally, so the many sites not synchronized but independently, so combust and produce this kind of partly reduced surface, and then in this surface, MO can decompose. So there's very limited time, but so summarize. So this non-linear reaction mechanism, I call it microscopic sequential reaction mechanism, can explain all the experimental phenomena, which cannot be explained by classical linear reaction mechanism such as Langmuir-Hirschfeld type or linear mechanism. A kind of oscillating reaction occurs on each active site. Not totally, independently it's important, not synchronized. So apparently we can observe only a steady reaction result. But the combination, combustion of hydrocarbon and then reduction of the active site, NO decomposition and oxidation of the site, and then absorption, this is cyclically, so oscillatory for each kinetic site. And this kind of site can be easily prepared by the so metal incorporated in the framework of the geodetic matrix. And finally, I would like to conclude. The most important factor to realize NO decomposition under excess oxygen condition are catalysts whose active sites disperse highly and stably, like us on the matrix of xenite material, and other condition is choice of suitable hydrocarbon whose combustion temperature range coincides with the temperature range of NO decomposition. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Inui. May I have some questions?
Probably you spoke so many things in a short time, so some of the audience may not understand.
Yes.
I already listened to his talk several times, and it might be appropriate to ask one small question. And what the point of your hypothesis is that on reduced surface, nitrogen oxygen site can be catalytically decomposed, and nitrogen and oxygen can be removed.
Yes.
But in the example you showed at, in the beginning of your slide, you showed the example of iron oxide.
Mm-hmm.
In that case, nitrogen can decompose, but oxygen does not come out in that case. So
Yes.
It would be very appropriate to show some example on in which
because
the NO decompose the reduced surface,
yes,
and the oxygen also can be removed.
No, only partly maybe oxygen molecule come out, but at lower temperature range, almost the oxygen produced by decomposition immediately caused by surface.
Yeah.
But more so always so oxygen.
The point is oxygen,
yes,
cannot is caught and cannot come out.
Maybe cannot come out.
In that case, you don't have catalytic decomposition, so
no,
the data show that
always hydrocarbon induced. But the oxidation of the partly reduced surface is not so fast. If the temperature range is around 400, between 300 and 400 degrees C, so there is a chance to before completely deoxidized, before some very short period, there is a chance to decompose.
I
for
understand your concept, but is there any
interest? Okay, I think it's a long flight back to Japan.
Yes, because it needs some very so many knowledge for oscillating reaction.
Okay.
Yes.
This is all from so many interesting things. I have just a small problem.
Yes.
Question: how to synchronize your local oscillation?
Yes.
And as I understand, you made your work on the high pressure.
Yes, of course, as you know, oscillating reaction depends on, so very deeply on the condition of, but in this case, only oxygen is excess. And NO and the hydrocarbon is very, very small amount,
yes,
concentration. And in your case, use some so crystal surface.
But our case, or more important thing is that for active site locating very systematically and then very highly dispersed on the matrix of the geometry, it's a different. So you are lecture video, that this kind of reaction occurs very so isolatedly active site.
Sometimes you can achieve to have a gas phase synchronization. We can discuss this.
Okay. So it means that adjust the three kind of conditions.
You're arguing that the hydrocarbon increases NO reduction because it will reduce the surface. Would CO have the same effect?
Of course, everybody so has known that if we add CO or hydrogen inside, in front of the reactor, this kind of reduced material easily can combust immediately. So there is no effect. But
it reacts too fast, you're saying?
Too fast, yes. So the, too fast. But if for the reaction catalyst zone, if the trajectory evolved in fully evolved all over the catalyst zone, it is effective. Because if we choose a suitable hydrocarbon too much fast, like a sedan, a partial oxidized, it's important.
Something like ethylene would not work either.
Ethylene is too easily combusted, so we can get some partly results. So we recommend some kind of acetone or that. So this kind of molecule needs much oxygen at the surface, and then it means so power of reduction is big. It's effective for this kind of reaction.
Yes. Other questions?
The last conclusion was very important because you mentioned that both reactions should occur at the same time.
That's
and
right.
This is a very important
adjustment is a necessary condition.
Tommy, just a short question.
Yes.
You speak about incorporation of copper and cobalt.
Yes.
You mean copper and cobalt is in the framework or is that just trapped in the framework?
Yes.
And is there any proof that's incorporated in the framework? And if so, how can the redox properties come in?
It's some of the different story. It depends on the kind of metal and more deeply depends on the method of preparation. But most major part of cobalt, for example, iron more easily, and gallium and gallium.
Okay, gallium is clear.
Yes,
but
clear.
Cobalt and
iron is more good. And then the copper is very difficult to do, only very small amount.
Look, in the case of the azeolite, you can put much more copper in. And then in the case of the CSM5, and that reminds me a little bit, that you have inside of the zeolite, the copper, but it's not incorporated in the frame, it's more entrapped as a cluster or something like that.
No.
And then you can...
I don't recommend A-type zeolite, even if we get higher result. Because in case of A-type or Y-type, H-type, it needs much aluminium, still much aluminium need to so consist of the crystal structure. It's not high thermal stability, especially with resistance of steel. But in case of high silica zeolite, like GSM5 and beta zeolite, maybe it will find a successful way.
Okay, maybe we can